In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize a URL on your KW agent website, in addition to how to add a page to your menu at this time. So on the left-hand side, I'm going to go over here to my sites tab to open the agent websites dashboard. Okay, now what we have here on the first tab, these are landing pages that we've created off our website, just regular landing pages. These are agent site pages that are actually on our website. And the third tab there are neighborhood pages that we've set up for our customers. So you want to go over to agent site pages. Okay, when you create a new page, like I've taught you with adding your home value calculator or your blog or your mortgage calculator or your free home buyer's guide, any of those things that you're adding after you set up your website on the Kelly Guide, you're adding new pages. Well, they're actually gonna need to be added to your menu after they show up here. They don't automatically show up. And let me show you what I mean by menu. So if I go to ballengrouphomes.com, which is my KW website, and I go up to the right-hand side and I look at this menu, these items don't just show up every time you build a page. You have to add it yourself, okay? So how you do that is once your page is created, go up here to Agent Site Settings. And then there's actually three tabs. We have Domains, Theme, and Pages. So we're going to go over here to Pages. And on the left-hand side here, you can see what your current menu looks like, okay? Now let me warn you of something. See this URL slug? This is, when I said customize your URL, this is what comes after your main domain name. So look over here at my website up top. See where it says ballenvegas.com? But if I go down to my free home buyer's guide, those keywords change to home-buyers-guide. This is your URL. This whole thing right here is your URL. And then everything after the slash is called the slug. So the keywords that come after the slug are what identify that individual page. If you change it, your page breaks. So don't change these after you have preset them. Now, if you've trained with me on WordPress and some of the other things, we have systems in place to catch that. KW Command at this time does not. So don't change your URL after you have set it, or when somebody types it in, the browser is not going to know where to go because there's no longer that address, okay? It's like changing the address on your house and not giving a mail forward to anybody to send your mail. The mail is going to get returned to them, and that's what's going to happen here. It's going to return a 404 page, and it's going to bounce. It's going to be, sorry, we can't find that page, okay? So don't change it after the fact. Leave this right now. All right, if you've created a new page, what you do is down here at the bottom, go to this little plus sign. Let me see if I can make that a little bit bigger for you. See down here and click Add Page. Now give your page a title. So maybe I'm going to add all my YouTube videos or something. So maybe I'm going to put real estate videos. Actually, I should do that now that I'm thinking about it. Real estate videos. And my URL slug is going to be real-estate-videos. Now the SEO description. This is usually about 150 characters. So it's like a sentence or two short sentences. And it's basically when somebody types a search into Google, San Diego real estate, and they land on the search engine results page. See these two lines right here? One line right here, one line. That's the SEO description. Everybody thinks it's to help rank on the search engines, and although it has really an indirect assistance a little bit, it's really so that you can control what shows up here on the search engine results page, okay? So here I would put something like, learn everything you need to know about buying or selling real estate in Las Vegas, Nevada with these real estate videos courtesy of Lori Ballen team. That URL and that phone number are not necessary, but it's something that I do sometimes for various reasons, but I do like to have my information handy, especially when I'm on a somebody else's website, which is technically what KW Command is there. It's KW's website that they're basically letting me borrow, I guess, if right now. Okay. Now see on the bottom, it says error 155 maximum characters. So if you have too many characters, just backspace that. Okay. And then save changes. All right, and then it'll tell you you have to select a page. So click select a page. Now you find whatever your page is that goes with that you already created. So I would have one on here called real estate videos. Or if I don't yet, I'm going to click on this new create a new site, and I'm gonna create a page for my real estate videos. So just keep in mind that this step is necessary right now every single time you add a new page. Once you've finished, click Save Changes, go over to your website, make sure it's showing up in the menu.